It looks like you had been doing a bit of volunteering around Philadelphia. So can you just tell me a bit about that?
Yeah, so I kind of felt helpless sitting at home here 24/7. It felt like I'm watching all my friends who are in the healthcare industry, and you know, they're basically in tears after their shifts dealing with this virus. So I thought there had to be a way that I could get more involved with, you know, trying to help out in the community and, you know, feel a little more active in this process.
Was there something you did before this all happened? Did you volunteer, you know, in other aspects of the Philadelphia community?
Yeah, there's a couple things. I've been involved with Philadoptables for a while, which is it's an organization that helps, you know, shelter animals. Preston and Steve Camp Out for Hunger is another one I've helped out at, but nothing like what I've been doing lately, working in the warehouses and packaging up non-perishable and perishable food items for families that are in need.
Yeah, can you tell me a little bit about like details of what the day or days entail?
I looked up online some volunteer opportunities, and I found it through the Mayor's Corp portal specific to the coronavirus, but they have all sorts of opportunities. And the one that stuck out to me was a warehouse job, because I've worked in a warehouse growing up. It was my first job ever, actually, so I figured if there was like anything that I can apply what I've learned in the past, it'd be that one. And they're 2-hour shifts, so you go in there, and the first day they had me just moving empty boxes from one side of the warehouse to the other so that people on the assembly line could package them with the food. I know it's a little thing, but you know, it makes me feel more accomplished with my day after I do those shifts.
You kind of had like a call to action in your post when you talked about it on social media. Have you gotten any of your other teammates to join you?
Well, I had a really good response. One that sticks out was Austin Shanks with Halifax there. You mentioned that he reached out to his municipality to see if there was any opportunities for him to get involved. So I feel like, you know, as a professional athlete, I have a fairly large following in the Philadelphia community. And if, you know, if people were feeling like me and, you know, wanted to get more involved, I wanted them to know that these opportunities are out there. You know, I think there's a, I guess an ownership that you have to take is, you know, someone who, you know, some people look to in the community, you know, that they can possibly follow.
I want to go back to what you said in the beginning, because I know you also mentioned it in your post and in your call to action, which was if you're feeling helpless in this fight against COVID-19. So has it kind of helped you? Like, do you feel less helpless after volunteering?
Yeah, for sure. It's I think it's very rewarding to be able to, you know, to feel like you're not just sitting at home, and you know, there's no shame in that, obviously, but just as me, and if I were to look at it as my team, you know, and if someone's doing a lot of the heavy lifting, which our healthcare workers and our essential workers are doing, you know, I can't just sit idly by and watch that. So I would want to get involved, and this has kind of filled that void for me.
Is there anything else that you want to say to fellow players or fans, or anything else you're doing to volunteer in the community?
Yeah, I'm actually fostering a cat as of 2 weeks ago now. So we're trying to learn to vibe. Did she? Oh yeah, she just cut across the back there. She's 18 years old. She's on her 9th life. She was timestamped for euthanasia, and then she got one of these foster families picked her up and had. I guess she had bad teeth, so they pulled out all her teeth, basically. She's got one tooth in the front.
Can we see her? Can she make an appearance?
Yeah, she doesn't like being picked up, though. she gets a little stiff when I pick her up, but she's never clawed me and obviously can't bite me because she doesn't have teeth, but she's pretty cute.
Oh, she so, just said hi.
We're trying to vibe. She's not too affectionate with me yet.
I keep
feeding her. Hopefully that'll change.
She doesn't look too happy. Wait, you didn't tell us her name. What's her name?
Lucy. Up for adoption if anyone's interested in a senior cat.
Okay. You know who to call.